Hello, everyone, and welcome back to another episode of Arizona Cardinals Franchise. We are now officially in Wild Card Weekend, where we have finished 14-3, and we are the one seed. The Cowboys also finished 14-3, but we got the tiebreaker over them. So here is the Wild Card matchups. The Cowboys will play the Eagles, the Lions will play the Seahawks, and the Packers will play the Buccaneers. And then Tommy also was the one seed. He ended up winning his game. He's got the Chargers as the two seed. Ravens fall all the way to the five seed. So he could actually get the Ravens in the first round, which would be a very scary opponent. He does not want to play the Ravens, and I do not want to play the Cowboys. We also here have a ton of storylines. So let's check out these storylines that we have in the Wild Card Weekend. Sweet, perfect. Do we get a bonus to our rushing attack? Your entire offense earns 2,500 XP for proving your offense does not have a weakness. That's really good, 2,500 XP, you love that. Now, here's the Marvin Harrison Jr. expectation. I know he got his yards, but did he get his catches? I was listening to the Pivot podcast this morning about, he said he was impressed that he met the expectations you set for him. Perfect. Now, does Marvin Harrison Jr. get a ton of XP for that? 9,000 XP for Marvin Harrison Jr. That's at least a skill point for him. And now we got two storylines here as well. So Marvin Harrison Jr. and the offense doing very well. Well, apparently Ryan Clark, remember back in week 5 when you told the press you get 10 to 5 wins? He was talking about how good of a job you did. You exceeded the number of wins you promised, and your players all earned 4,500 XP, and you get 7 staff points. Holy shit, we are getting so much fucking XP going into the playoffs, which is much needed, by the way. Hey, coach, take advantage of this bye week to come up with a wrinkle for the rest of the playoffs. Great. Who is one player you feel like could be a secret weapon for us during this playoff run? I feel like it should be someone they aren't game planning for. Oh, yeah, Troy Benson. Yeah, our backup running back. How do you want to use him? Let's make sure his catching gets work. Let's have him work on breaking tackles. Let's have him work on change of direction. Definitely let's do change of direction. Is Troy Benson going to get just a boost to his change of direction here? Five plus boost to catching for playoffs. I fucking picked change of direction. Apparently that doesn't fucking matter, I guess. And now weekly strategy, me and Tommy both agreed that we just weren't going to do weekly strategy just so that we can get into the games fast, just so we can get into next week faster. So no weekly strategy for us. And now I am going to advance to the divisional round, and Tommy has already as well. Now we get to see our opponents here. If we view the playoff bracket here, who are we playing? I am playing the Eagles. And Tommy is playing the Jets. Now, Tommy is 1-1 against the Jets. Beat them once, lost them once. So that's an interesting matchup for him. He's lucky, though. The Chiefs lost, but the Ravens did win. So Tommy's either going to have to play the Ravens or the Chargers in the divisional if he makes it. For me, I don't know how happy I am to play the Eagles. I'm glad that the Cowboys are out of there, but the Eagles are still a very high-powered team as well. Having to play the Eagles in the divisional does not sound like a fun matchup at all for me. And now we got a new storyline here in the divisional. Let's see what our defensive coordinator has to say. All right. Shift our focus to the playoff game against the Eagles. Their D-tackle will cause problem for our center. Dude, a fucking toddler would cause problems for our center. He's that ass. Team meeting room. Big week for us. As you know, we're facing the Eagles in the playoffs this week. In film study this morning, we talked about how Jalen Carter could cause problems for our center. What is our plan to deal with this? Yes, pass blocking power. We need to work on pass block power with him. Is our center going to get a pass blocking power boost? Please? Your lineman is receiving... Yes! Oh my god, our fucking center is getting a boost. Holy shit, that's massive. And now, we have a ass ton of players we can develop. Why was there a yellow there? Like, I don't even know what the yellow means. Now, Marvin Harrison Jr. here, he got 2 skill points. and we're going to use them both on playmaker. Come on, give him a speed upgrade here. Maybe we have to do deep threat to get speed. So I'll do deep threat. Come on, give me speed, baby. Damn. No speed for Marvin Harrison Jr., which would have been really happy. Look at his acceleration, though. And his... Oh my god, Marvin Harrison Jr. is already a beast. Marvin Harrison Jr. is an 89 overall, and he's a rookie. 89, superstar dev. Fuck you, Ritter. I'm not upgrading you. Our backup tight end, rookie, he got 2 skill points. Good for him. Why is he at -2 morale? Whatever. I'm not going to fucking question it. Our backup tight end is -2 morale for some reason, but he is now up to a 71 overall. Damn, we're going to have a lot of people here. Damn, all these people actually only get 1 skill upgrade, but it's really important that we focus on these. James Conner, it actually doesn't matter. Jalen Thompson, this being like your only skill point this year, isn't really too appealing to me. +3 hit power, +2 man, +2 tackle. That is pretty appealing to me. Trey Benson here only got 1 skill point, and let's use it on rushing back here for him. +3 ball carrier vision and some other stuff there. That's pretty good. Will Hernandez is going to get a much-needed boost as well. Will Hernandez did not allow a single sack for us this season. He played out of his mind. Paris Johnson Jr. getting a skill point is also massive for us as well. He is now up to an 81 overall, and he's only in his second year. He will be a really good future left tackle for us. Michael Wilson getting a skill point is also massive. I don't disagree with upgrading the playmaker for him. Hopefully he gets a speed upgrade. Awesome. Kyler Murray here. Do I just make Kyler Murray an 80 overall? No, I think I need to continue doing field general. Kyler Murray just needs to work on that medium accuracy. Throw up accuracy, medium, great. +2 awareness, what the fuck's that going to do? But Kyler Murray needs to work on that fucking accuracy so damn bad. BJ Ojulari is going to be now up to a 78 overall. He started the season as a 72, so BJ Ojulari goes up 6 overall, which is massive for us. Darius Robinson also was a 72 overall. Or maybe BJ Ojulari was a... BJ Ojulari might have been a 71 overall. But him and Darius Robinson are the same overall now. Ooh, Max Melton getting another skill point is big for us. Max Melton, the second round rookie. I believe he's star dev, right? Yeah, star dev. He's coming up nicely for us. Our fucking dog shit left guard. Fuck this guy, man. This guy is so ass, Isaiah Adams. I mean, dude just gets... It's just trash. Needs to be replaced ASAP. Ooh, Elijah Jones, who was playing slot in third corner for us, man. He did great this season. +2 man coverage is massive. Anyone else of importance? I don't think so. We will let the CPU just boost 27 players. Yeah, that's just a bunch of depth players, players that don't matter. And now let's do our weekly strategy here. This is important for us. We will just do half pads and half pads. And now we can work on our guys here. I was able to get gold with everyone except Benson. I got silver. I was like 500 off, and I'm like, I don't really want to do the running back one again. So now here we're going into our game against the Philadelphia Eagles. We got some players we can upgrade with all the training that we just did. Hopefully some impactful guys for us. And it'll be Trey McBride. That is a pretty impactful guy, actually. Trey McBride now goes up to an 86 overall. It's a ton of good statistics to go with that as well. And now let's go over this Eagles roster. This is a team that we have not yet faced. Let's see how the Eagles are doing this year. Eagles have AJ Brown, who's a 97 overall, Lane Thomas, who's a 97 overall, Saquon Barkley, who's a 95 overall, Jalen Hurts, who's a 93 overall, Darius Slay, who's a 92 overall, Devontae Smith, who's a 90 overall, Dallas Goedert, who's an 88 overall, Jeremiah Lotta, who's an 88 overall, Lane Dickerson, oh my fucking god. So 93 quarterback, 93 running back, 90 wide receiver, 97 wide receiver, 88 tight end, 88 left tackle, 86 guard, 82 center. Dog shit right guard though. Yeah, so basically just what I'm seeing here is we're screwed. That's kind of what I'm seeing. Oh, Eagles 89 overall offense. Perfect. I'm sure that us losing three of the last four is not going to affect this in any way, shape, or form. And now we just got to be on our A game against the Eagles, man. Just got to be on our A game. Oh, look at that. Kyler Murray and Jalen Hurts staring eye in eye, looking savagely at one another. Kyler Murray has yet to get a playoff win, so he's looking for his very first playoff win in the divisional round here. We are home in State Farm Arena, and we're getting the ball first. I kind of actually wanted the ball first here. I don't hate that, just so that I can try to set the tone with my offense, because my offense has been pretty bad as of late. And now here we go. Very first play of the divisional round between the Cardinals and the Eagles. And it will be a... I don't know why Marvin Harrison Jr. stopped. I really don't get why Marvin Harrison Jr. stopped on that play. Okay, whatever. Fine. But second and five for the Cardinals here. And Zay Jones is wide open. Zay Jones is easily able to get a massive play there, but he couldn't get a fucking 2-yard catch last week. Still blows my mind. First and 10 now for the Arizona Cardinals. Zay Jones is going to be open again, but I'm going to get fucking hit as I throw and almost throw an interception. I see our offensive line is currently in prime form right now. Absolutely ecstatic to see that from our boys. And now... God, our left tackle is terrible. Our left guard is ass. We have the worst fucking left guard in fucking history. Look at our left guard and our center trying to double block someone right now. How is this fucking possible? Also, everyone's covered right now. Actually, Zay Jones might have been open for a touchdown, but I wouldn't have had time to throw it to him because my fucking center and my left guard are fucking terrible. I hands down have the worst fucking center and worst fucking guard, left guard of all time. It's disgusting. Kyler Murray actually is going to run here, and Kyler Murray is going to slide and pick up the first down. What a fucking find from Kyler Murray there. Excellent, excellent play. And now first and 10 on the 20-yard line. We're officially in the red zone. I am going to give the handoff here to Trey Benson. We have a lot of youth on this Cardinals team who has not experienced a playoff game yet. Trey Benson, Marvin Harrison Jr., Harris Johnson Jr., Trey McBride. A lot of youth on this team. And now Trey Benson with a nice run up the middle has two rushes for 12 yards. We have first and goal from the 7. I'm going to be looking for Michael Wilson on this. If not Michael Wilson, Zay Jones. Michael Wilson, that should be a touchdown. And Benson is going to get in for a touchdown. Thank God. I was really fucking unhappy with what just happened there with Michael Wilson. But Trey Benson marches into the end zone. We score a touchdown on our opening drive. A much, much, much needed touchdown to show our offense that we can still do it if we absolutely need to. Now we kick the ball here with Matt Prater. And now let's see what our defense can do against this 89 overall Eagles offense. First and 10 here. Oh yeah, I forgot Jalen Hurts does this weird-ass fucking squat thing. And they hand it off to Saquon Bart... That I swear to God, if that's somehow a penalty on me, if that is somehow a fucking penalty on me in any way, shape, or form. Holding. Offensive holding, and now, do we do 2nd and 13 or 1st and 20? I'm actually going to do 2nd and 13 here. I just think the less plays we give this Eagles offense, the better. It's essentially just like on their 1st and 20, they picked up 7 yards is how I see it. And now it is 2nd and 13. And, well, fuck me, I've chose the wrong play. And a lot of motion I've realized in this game. Like, just a lot of motion all around. Jalen Hurts is going to get fucking sacked. Who is that? I actually don't know who number 56 is. I know that's not Darius Robinson. That might have actually been Darius Robinson that just got the sack. I'm there. You know what? I don't get the interception, but I forced the incompletion with Zay Jones. With fucking Zaven Collins. I don't get the pick. But that's fine. I forced the incompletion. The Eagles have to punt the football to us. Great start. We get a touchdown and we force the Eagles to have to punt. That's exactly what we like to see. And now hopefully we can score some more points here and not be ass. Ooh, Trey Benson with some very appealing speed there. And now it is going to be the end of the first quarter, and we are going to be up 7-0 on the Philadelphia Eagles. We got a second and inches play here. What we has learned is just pick up the first down. Do not do anything stupid here. Do not take a sack. Just get your free yards here. Benson picks up a nice first down, 5 rushes for 38 yards in total for us. And Benson's doing so well for us. I think we're going to give him another handoff here. Oh, the Eagles are sending the house. If Benson can get to the outside, he's got massive yardage, and he does. He beats Chauncey Gardner-Johnson. And Troy Benson now has 6 rushes for 68 yards, dude. When Troy Benson has a good game, he has a really good game. He's just able to take it up a second notch with his elite speed. Now, Trey McBride is going to get this catch here. And, oh my God, shake off a guy there. Very nice play there from Trey McBride to pick up 9 yards. And now we got a 2nd-and-1 situation going on here. Or guess what? Mr. Benson is going to get the handoff on this play right now as I speak. And Benson is able to pick up 4 yards. And we have a 1st-and-goal from the 6-yard line now, where we are going to once again run the ball here with Trey Benson. Some thriveting gameplay here, but Benson rushes in for his 2nd rushing touchdown of the day. Troy Benson, in his rookie playoff debut, already has 2 touchdowns. This Eagles defense has no stop for him, and we are up 14-0. Now, the Eagles opening kickoff took them to the 28-yard line, and now, oh my God, I thought Jones was about to have an interception. I thought the rookie Jones was about to pick off Jalen Hurts there, but instead, A.J. Brown gets a very nice reception, and the Eagles are already on their own 47-yard line, and Saquon Barkley gets a very nice rush there, and it is now 2nd-and-4. Damn. 2nd-and-4, Hurts does a nice little dump-off pass there to Devontae Smith, and now this looks like a running formation, to be honest. This looks like a running formation. Jets sweep, really? No, they are running it with Saquon. And they pick up 5 yards. They're on the run. Oh, God, I didn't realize it's already at the 2-minute warning. Shit. And here we are at the 2-minute warning. Let's try to do some little bend, don't break defense here, boys. There's like, how am I supposed to cover everyone? Oh, my God, I do cover everyone. And is that Darius? That is Darius Robinson. Darius Robinson already has 2 fucking sacks. He had 3 sacks all year, and Robinson now has 2 sacks in this game against the Philadelphia Eagles. Oh my God, Buda Baker. I don't know how Buda Baker didn't pick that off, but at least it forced an incompletion. Now the Eagles are seriously doing a 61-yard field goal here. Let's see if Their kicker had... Oh my God, the Eagles just made a fucking 61-yard field goal with Jake Elliott. That's pretty dumb. But now we're getting the ball back with 1:40 to attempt to try and do something here. And we're starting on our own 27-yard line. Let's see here. 1st-and-10. We'll just get fucking annihilated right away. And who's doing this again? Is this just my left guard that just is getting absolutely creamed? Yep, dude, my left guard just needs to fucking go. My left guard is gone in the offseason. I can fucking promise you that. He's a rookie, though. That's the worst part about it, too. Rookie left guard just... Okay. I want to try that again because I felt like that was working. Don't really know what the fuck just happened there. Okay. Okay. And that was certainly a fucking possession. Is he going to be able to get a return on this? Oh my God, I just fucking smoked him with the hit stick, though. Now the Eagles have the ball on their own 33 with all 3 of their timeouts. Lovely. Jalen Hurts is doing his little squatty potty thing. And that Dallas Goedert, it's someone, that's all I know. That's a big guy. AJ Brown's doing inappropriate things to me, and I am not a fan of it. Collins, what the fuck? There's so many, like, interceptions. I could have, like, Jalen Hurts is throwing some fucking balls that are this fucking close to being picked off, man. Oh, that's not one of them, though. Oh, great fucking tackle there by Zaven Collins. And the Eagles just scored in, like, fucking 2 seconds. So that's really appealing. That's really attractive. That's just super fucking hot. Now it is 14-10. 4 plays, 67 yards in 23 seconds. 23 seconds to go 67 yards and score a touchdown. All right. Let's try this wide receiver screen because I'm stubborn and just want this to work. Oh my god, it finally worked. And it picks up 10 yards. We'll call a timeout. Why not? Oh yeah, baby. 4 verts. That's what I'm talking about. Maybe Marvin Harrison Jr. can be open on this play. Who fucking knows? Definitely not. Oh my god, Trey McBride was actually wide open, and I didn't see that. How is number 55 keeping... I just got fucking pile-drived into the ground after I stepped out of bounds. Hello? No one gives a fuck about Kyler. This guy's wide open. Just get down. Fuck you, Zay Jones. Fuck you, man. Fuck you, Jones, dude. Come on. Now we got 3rd and 2. We'll just run the ball with Benson. Go back to what we know fucking works. Good shit, Benson. Benson's able to deflect some catches there. Now, as long as we at least get a fucking field goal out of this drive, it's a one possession game. Marvin Harrison Jr. could be wide open here on a streak route. Let's just do this to Trey McBride. Trey McBride's got fucking a ton of space, and he's able to step out of bounds. We're now on the 16-yard line. 24 seconds left. I like Wilson. I like Trey McBride. I just pressed the wrong button. I was trying to throw that to Trey McBride. That's 100% on me. I just pressed the wrong button there. 1,000,000% on me. I'm looking at Trey McBride. I'm literally eyeing him down. I'm just like, fuck it. Let's throw it to Trey McBride. I pressed the wrong button and just fucking gift the Eagles with an interception. Uh-oh. Oh, and Saquon, you gotta be fucking kidding me right now. All right, the Eagles are just gonna let the clock run out. It's gonna be 14-10 halftime, but the Eagles are okay. I guess they're gonna be running a play. Oh, they just handed off again. We smoke Saquon, so Saquon just gets hit for fucking nothing. We're up 14-10 at halftime, but the Eagles do get the ball. It should not be 14-10. I honestly think realistically it would have been 21-10 if I didn't throw that interception. But at the very worst, it should be 17-10. But I pressed the wrong button, throw an interception, and now here we are. And our defense has to get a stop. Our defense has to get a stop on this play. And we'll see if they can.
God, dude.
Dude, the Eagles got like a fucking 100 tight ends. Now, 3rd and 1. I definitely agree with sending a blitz here in case they do run it with Saquon. This looks like a run with Saquon. Is this not? Maybe Jalen Hurts runs the ball here, but it is a run with Saquon. I'm all over it with that fucking Buda Baker. I'm all over that with Buda Baker. Sit down, Saquon. Sit down. You want to fucking leave the Giants and go to the Eagles to try to get a Super Bowl ring? Cardinals are on your way, dude. Troy Benson is the rookie is fucking outperforming you. And look at he's showing it off here. Oh my god. Oh, if Benson could have gotten around fucking 32 there, Blanken Rodrigo ship the fucking white safety. Holy shit, that would have been a fucking insane play by the GOAT. Troy Benson. And now Zay Jones is literally just fucking wide open here. He's got no spin move. But Zay Jones with a monster catch. And now we are already on the Eagles 40-yard line. And realistically, we just need 10 more yards to be in field goal range. So another first down puts us in business. Ass running on my part there. I couldn't make up my mind if I wanted to go left or right. And I just fucking went straight. Right into the line of fire. And so that one's on me for just being stupid as hell. And seriously, like, really, guys, like, fucking God, dude. Just my interior offensive line sucks so much horse cock. Worst fucking interior offensive line of all time. And now Benson just, please, are we even in field goal range? I don't know. Coach says we can make a fucking 56 yarder. We're about to find out. I did pretty good. No. We did not make the 56 yarder there. How close was that? Eh, not really close. All right, so I would say that our range is probably like 50 yards. I did have a little bit of power that I did leave off of that. So maybe we could hit a 56 yarder if I had max power. I don't really know. Okay, fuck you, Hurts. Just fucking creamed him. Oh my God, B.J. Ojulari gets to Hurts. I don't know how we have 3 sacks. Like, I really don't. The Eagles' offensive line is fucking phenomenal. But somehow B.J. Ojulari and Darius Robinson are actually balling out our fucking rookie edge rushers. And now 3rd and 12 here. If we can pick up a monster stop on 3rd and 12, this would be fucking insane. Come on, defense. We need you here. Oh my God, Jalen Hurts just had to throw the ball away. That's how fucking good our defense is. Defense is playing out of its fucking mind right now. This is our Colts. This is our team. We bleed blue for the shoe. All right. We're on the 27-yard line. And now let's just start running the football again. That's literally how we scored our 2 touchdowns on the first time. That's what the Eagles think we're going to do. We're not. We're going to pass the ball and drop it. Okay, sweet. Fuck yeah. All right, so we're going to run the ball up the middle here with Benson. And ideally pick up a first down. You know what? We pick up 6. The fuck did Troy Benson just do? It looks like he just... Oh, well, he's now hurt. Okay. And Marco Wilson here is just going to catch the ball here. Not do any funny business. Lower back strain, fuck it. We'll keep James Conner in. Why not? He's a veteran. Yo, James Conner, you're going to get a massive fucking run. You're going to get a huge fucking yardage on this run, Conner. I guess he is. Oh, shit. Thank you, James Conner. Greatly appreciated. And now, with the last play in the third quarter, I actually am going to run a play because I'm not a pussy like the CPU is a lot of the time. And fuck you, Kyler. Fuck you, Kyler. Fuck you, Kyler. Go to fuck, Kyler Murray. Just suck a wiener, dude. Suck a fucking wiener schnitzel, Kyler. Kyler Murray actively throwing. You fucking love to see it. James Conner here is going to have a nice little sexy run up the middle. Oh, fucking 10 out of 10 blocking from Troy McBride. Trey McBride with the best fucking blocking I've ever fucking seen in my life. Elite tier blocking by Trey McBride. Now here we are, 3rd and 4. I just ran this play, but I'm running it again, apparently, because Coach really fucking really likes this play. And come on, Jones. Oh yeah, I mean Wilson. Just go down, buddy. We're focusing on getting the W here. And that means not being stupid. And now, clearly, Marvin Harrison Jr. is going to be wide open here for a touchdown on this play. He got bumped in the middle of the route. He was wide open, but he got bumped. Oh, Benson's now back in. I'm so glad that that injury obviously wasn't fucking life-threatening or anything. Doctor gave him the fucking pills. And Troy Benson picks up a massive first down. 12 rushes for 100 yards. Coach, why do you love dive stutter flat so damn much, Coach? You're starting to piss me off with these stupid-ass play calls, Coach. Now, here we are, 1st and 10 on the 12. We're doing a play I have legit never run this entire fucking season. Kyler Murray's the fucking GOAT. Kyler Murray's the GOAT. Kyler's the GOAT. Kyler is the MVP. Dude, Kyler's that fucking dark horse candidate, am I right? And we pick up a yard, baby. And now 3rd and 9 on the 11. Guess what? I'm looking for fucking Benson or Harrison. Or running it up the middle with Kyler. Oh, Kyler's just going to fucking waltz into the end zone. Get tackled after he scored a touchdown. Should be a penalty. Now we have 3 rushing touchdowns on the day. 2 with Benson, 1 with Kyler. No passing touchdown. The Eagles do not have an answer for this run team. Now 1st and 10 on the 30. Jalen Hurts is strutting out. Wondering how have we only gotten 10 points of offense. We need to change this immediately. And what I'm going to do is I am going to throw the ball to do that. And we're like, you know what, Jalen? You are so smart. And you know what? Number 21, Williams. That's not even one of my starters is out there for some odd fucking... No, I don't know, dude. I just hate life. Okay. Kaiser White. What the fuck? All right. Well, this formation's been going great for us. I'm all over there with... And in 3 fucking plays, the Eagles score a touchdown. They waste no timeouts, they waste no clock, and the Eagles just march down the field in 3 fucking plays. Can we at least stop them from picking up the 2-point conversion? We actually can. BJ Ojulari, the GOAT. And we are now up by 5. We just need to get a couple of runs here to secure the W. And we're starting on the 41 with an amazing return from Michael Carter. All right, let's just not be stupid. And we'll win the football game. Oh my God, Trey Benson's got a massive hole. Oh my God, Trey Benson is already on the Eagles' 40-yard line. And we're just going to let this clock literally run to the 2-minute warning. Now we've learned that we can't make a 56-yarder. From where we are right now, it would be a 38-yarder. So we at least need to pick up a couple of yards before we can feel even safe about a field goal attempt. And we pick up 2, and if we were kicking from where we were right now, it would be a 56-yarder, which we were short on. So we need to gain some yards here. What better way to do that than running the ball with Trey Benson? We pick up 1 yard. All right, I feel like we kind of have to pass in this situation, and Marvin Harrison Jr. is going to be our savior on this outplay, right, Marvin? Maybe not. Maybe just Trey Benson here. Can he pick up the first and just end our suffering? Oh my God, he did. We're going to take 3 knees, and we're going to win 21-16. No reason for us to stat pad at all. It's the playoffs. It doesn't count. And the Arizona Cardinals have officially beaten the Philadelphia Eagles 21-16. Now, if we look at the player stats of our divisional round, Jalen Hurts, 12 for 15 passing, 196 yards, 2 touchdowns. Kyler Murray, 11 for 22, 0 for 1, 1 interception. If you're looking at this, you think we won. But if you look at the running here, Trey Benson is a GOAT in his rookie running game. And he was the primary reason why we won that game. Trey Benson, with that incredible performance, gets a skill upgrade from it, which is much deserved. And I think I'm going to upgrade his power back, honestly, just to try to make him a more well-rounded running back. Plus 2 break tackle, plus 1 stiff arm. Perfect. Now, we will advance the week here. See if Tommy has already played his game. He has. He hasn't said anything to me, which means that he probably won. Do the playoff bracket here. That'd be hilarious if he lost. Oh, he absolutely kicked the shit out of the Jets, but now he has to play the Ravens. I know he was not looking forward to that matchup. But unfortunately, he's got the Ravens, and I got the Packers, and the Cardinals and the Packers actually have a history. And I know I've played the Packers. I forget what happened in our game, to be honest. But anyways, guys, thank you so much for watching. As always, leave comments down below on how I can improve the series for you guys, and peace out.